Oh, is it here?
Red.
Okay.
Would you get chicken? Oh my God.
See, Richard, only one person could pull this off.
That's right. Yeah. That's right.
Kind of scary, isn't it?
Thank you.
Okay, Richard, can I have just a minute? I just want to get you on camera for just a minute here.
Sure.
Well, just a few things. Mm-hmm. I want to know, in a brief moment, from one man to another, one who's had 75 years of experience, is there anything that you want to tell one of us in the younger generation? Just, and if you had to sum it up in 1 minute or less, what would you say? Pressure.
It's over.
What's that?
Wait, when you ready?
I'm ready.
One, how much time I got?
How much time you have? How about 1 minute?
Stay focused on your goal all the way. Stay focused on your goal. And establish them and stay focused on it, and you can achieve it.
That sounds like Richie.
John has a really is the one. She twisted her arms. She was the brain behind it. So it's amazing. And I love this place. I've never seen this place before. But where we are right now is both elegant and intimate. I know that you like it as well as I do. I want to thank all of these that have come, because I think that this place is richer. With all of you loving them enough to come out today. Now, I have to ask that in lieu of gifts, your contributions to Walt, she told you what that acronym stands for. It's a horrible name. It's a name that I give. But will you be lost? Peace and prosperity. Now, can there be anything more inflated and stuffy? So we simply reduced it to its initials, W-A-L-I-P-E.
Yeah. support, man. You know, so much push by everybody to do better and all that. Until it really makes me feel good to be able to be a part of a family like this. I wish my mother and my father and my uncle would see that I didn't end up in the penitentiary. I'm part of a strong family, and I'm very supportive and very appreciative of all of you all that stay, because I think that's what it takes. And to be a part of what they're doing with Wild over at PSU, with these boys who might go off track and run for a while, I think that's absolutely wonderful. And I hope that more than just money, I hope that we can, you know, support it from a concept point of view, because I think this is probably what's more needed in the community of the city. I was talking to Melvin Hartley, and I was asking him, I said, man, they got this going on over at PSU, and I think that they probably like to get involved in it, because they're trying to just speak to these things and say, we'd be glad to do that. And I told him, I said, man, I'm just going to get crack out of the black community. Black people have to do that. I have the right to do that. And the AIDS problem and all the problems we got, I think now at this stage of life, we can kind of look and try to help with that and not wait for the government. And this little lady right here, I'd like to say something about her. This little lady, would you stand just in front of her? This little lady I met several years ago when she was in junior high school or grade school. Her father, grandfather, a friend of mine, Burt Bingham, Burt Plumbingham. And I had partners, and he was my plumber and my friend, and I'd go down to the farm and all that. But there was a little girl in the middle of all the chaos. She was always reading something. Everybody else going crazy, and she'd read. And she'd get herself up and get dressed and go to school. And she was She'd get herself up, get herself dressed, and go to school. Everybody else speak. What a fascinating child. And I saw her go to Rogers and the high school for law enforcement. And she always stayed in touch with me. Always stayed in touch with me. And she always surrounded herself with people that were academic. I've never heard of grade point averages like she talked about. 4.2.
Yeah.
Thank you.